Welcome back to Let's Play Amberstar Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, exploring, or continuing to explore, the town of Crystal. I think we came in the city here? No, I'm not sure. Or here. No, this is the Guild of Paladins, actually. But you have to go through all this crap just to get to them. I think we might have come in this city this way, though. So, I hope there's more to find. Really do. Yeah, I'm not even sure where the merchant is. This must be the merchant, then. The merchant in this case is a separate... Let me see. Yeah, the merchant's here. So that's all we've found so far, is this merchant and the Guild of Paladins. So there's gotta be more, man. There's just gotta be more. Apparently I am seeing more. Dead end. Very twisty, windy. We've got plaques all around here. This large sign says, Marketplace of Crystal. I guess they all say that. Just gotta make sure, you know? So where's the market? I'm going back to where I was. Let's turn around. So for a marketplace, there's a whole lot of nothing around here. This place is driving me mad. This way? What am I facing? I'm facing this way. Where is everything? There's really not much here. The sign says enter food store, open to 7 to 10 hours? 17 hours. Well, that's not now. It's a different message than in Twin Lake. As you try to open this door, you realize it is locked. After you knock, you hear murmurings. It is closed. Come again some other time. I like that. So I'm just gonna wait. I mean, it's just food stores, but let me wait for stuff to open up. There's 7 to 17 hours, I believe, so they open up pretty early. Yeah. And they close early. Thank you. Still closed. There's nothing really to do here, just selling rations. Which is what I figured, but... you never know if these people, you know, might end up be a place you can walk around inside, like the merchant there. So let's... keep heading south then around this. Yeah, unexplored stuff ahead. Endo. Jeez. All these dead ends. Else here. Well, we've got this area where we first came in. We've got a little bit up here. We might as well head up that way. I think I'm facing this way. Let me just test that. Yes. Got a door here, so we're gonna end a dead end. Ouch! The sign says, Temple of Bela, come in if you seek peace. Okay. This looks like more stone walls and stuff. Okay, where are we now? Just check it out. Okay. Temple of Bela, tucked our way up here. Okay, I guess he just heals you. Looks like we don't even have enough money for a heal. They might resurrect dead party members. I'm sure we don't have enough money for that. Exiting Temple of Bela. On this green sign, you can read, The best ships come from my shipyard. Come in. Signed, Captain Carlos. Open 9 to 20 hours. Captain Carlos. Okay. I wonder how much it is for a ship. Some amount that we do not sufficiently have. I lost my bearing here. Am I back to the shipyard? Damn it, I got turned around. Jeez. No whining. Everything's tucked away. As you open the door, you see an old man clothed in tattered old rags. He is sitting on a wooden box, searching through a pile of bones lying on the floor before him. When he notices you, he looks up from the bones and stares at you with a strange, absent gaze. What you doing with those bones? That's how small you are? You don't get any bigger, huh? I thought he was like another step away from me or something. Talking to yourself is a sign of madness. Oh, here he is. I guess he must have moved the same time I did. Furlass. I think that's the sign for adding to guild, so we can't add him to guild under the exit there. I can't move the cursor over. Hello. Welcome. My name is Furlass. Did you happen to find a bone somewhere? A bone. Yes, my bone of wisdom. I must tell you that I can read the future from bones when I throw them on the ground. But unfortunately, I have lost my most important bone. Some time ago, I was called to Twin Lake by the Lord Chancellor Carwayne to help him with a problem with his sewers. But unfortunately, he did not want to believe me that the sewers aren't the rats. He did not want to believe me that the rats are the evil in the sewers. When I left Twin Lake, I must have lost one of my bones. Alright, well, Carwayne. Who's this guy? Furlass. I'm just gonna write this down. Furlass. Ask. Furlass and Crystal, actually. Write that. Ask Carwayne about bones, parentheses, S? Or maybe in sewers. That's good. We died in the sewers, and hopefully now we have an actual, well, we have two quests to go, well, possibly go to the sewers, unless Carwayne has one of his bones. Can I ask him about Carwayne? It's not on the list. What about this cat? No. I don't want to give him gold. Nothing about a quest. Sewers. You can't say anything about the sewers, huh? Rats? Or... probably not. Don't say anything about Carwayne. Just try, Twin Lake. Oh, alright, I guess we're done with him. He doesn't know about the Rose of Sadness, whatever it's called. I already did that. Now, yeah, there's more. Not yet. Alright. So Furlass wants this stuff. And where is he? Dead end. So let's see. Dead end. Northeast-ish. So I can find the guy later. See if Carway knows anything about your bones, dude. That's So then and there. Alright, we need to check this. Checked it. Alright, that's really it for this section of town. The only other place I can see is here and here. I'm hoping there's something interesting going on in one of those areas. Pretty far away from all that. Unfortunately. Do I go this way? I can get around that way. Down here, maybe? Yes. Although this probably not gonna be much, but I don't know. We'll find out. Am I taking that? Yeah. There's a door of some kind. Oh, it's a dead end. What the hell that's doing? What is that there for? An iron sign hangs here. It shows a green jewel, and below it, blue letters read, Guest House, the Jewel. So this way, definitely going in there, don't worry, I'm just looking over here. I might as well just map this out, which just involves going up to like this. Okay. So we've got the jewel is there, and then we've got whatever else is there. After the jewel, this is our only destination to finish exploring this city. Or town, rather. Town. That's the way out. Okay, into the jewel. A guest house. Or tavern. Or both. He moved and his appearance changed. A man with a black beard and a patch over one eye speaks to you. Hello, good people. I am Captain Brix. But you perhaps... Have you perhaps seen Orlando? I have just sailed into the harbor and am unloading the wine he ordered. Orlando. She's one of those... One line, one paragraph people. I'm guessing these are chairs? Greetings! Hail, people! Wherever you are. There's a person. Is that an axe or something? Probably the owner up there. A young man with a 3-day beard speaks to you. Hello, my name is Karsten. Are you here because of the cook's specialty? It is on the menu, but I always come too late and there's nothing left. I've come to think that the cook is eating it all himself. Perhaps. You never know. Ouch. Get over there. A middle-aged woman looks at you and says, "Are you perhaps looking for my husband, the landlord? If so, go through the kitchen door to the south. It leads to a corridor. Then take the right-hand door. You will find Orlando in the courtyard behind it." And I was looking for you, baby. Are these pictures? Sometimes pictures are interesting. This is not one of those times. Are these benches? Or chests? Is there benches? I can't even get over there to look at the bookcase or whatever it is. Are we talking about here? Karsten, I believe. The man before you stands 6 foot tall and has a beard. As you speak to him, he turns to you and says, "Hello, I am Eric, the Jewel's cook. Would you like to try one of my specialties? Curry chicken. Wait, I will bring some plates." Eric goes to one of the large pans in the kitchen, but then comes back empty-handed. "I am really sorry, but there's nothing left. Perhaps you could come again?" "Hey, I want some curry chicken." Curry's the bomb. So that's not him, it's the cook. Alright. Oh, I left. I didn't mean to do that. Oh, I did come through this way? I don't even know. I think I passed through a different way. Well, there was another door. Going this way. Where is everybody in this place? We need to find Karsten. Yo, Karsten! I can't walk over these plants. That might be Karsten. Let's go talk to him first. Oh, this is the man with the black beard, Captain Bricks. Except they did say he was out in the courtyard, so maybe I was going the right way. Because the courtyard is an outside area. Gryban. Oh, we can add him to party. Perhaps. Hello, Gryban. Welcome, my name is Gryban. Have you come to Crystal to join the Guild of Paladins? No. I guess you are a paladin? It is my greatest wish to become a paladin, to wear shining armor, to carry a bright sword, and to defend the good against the evil. But unfortunately, I will never get the gold together which I need to join the guild. Have you seen a bone? No. Surprised we won't say anything about Lyramion, the leader of the paladins, or something like that. Quest? Need money? Says he needs money. Okay, well, guessing he's a paladin, or not yet a paladin. I wonder if we can have him join immediately. Anything else here we want to ask him? Hoping he would know where we can find some gold. Alright, you wanna join our ragtag team of zeros? Hopefully one day to become heroes. Yes, naturally. How long have I already been waiting to get out of here? Would it be too much if I asked you to have me trained as a paladin? If we have enough money. I mean, it is right here, so that's convenient, but... if we found some more gold, that would be helpful. Hope he's not gonna have objections to us stealing stuff. Ah! The ledger! Nothing. What is this? Nothing. Somebody's sleeping out. Oh, it is nighttime. Guess we'll wait for this person to wake up. Got up! To use the bathroom, I guess. Hello. Hello, hello. Trasric. Ooh! There's a wizard already. Oh, he can join our party, and... he's a wizrad! He's a black wizrad. Interesting. Half-elf. Hmm. I suppose he might join our party. Hello, Trasric. Hello, I am Trasric, the black wizard. I mean the grain merchant. Can I help you? Black wizard. Psst. No so loud. We are not very popular at the moment, and I don't want to tempt the people to think about a lynching. Since Marmion went mad and attacked the Eternal Guards, we are being hunted again. It is really bad, but what can one do? Our guild is always falling into disrepute. Are any of you interested in joining the guild? You look very trustworthy, and I will therefore tell you where I have hidden the key, which will free the way to the tower of the guild. Search for the key in one of Olfin's flower pots. Olfin? Who's Olfin? Alright, well, I'm gonna write that down. Trasric. Jewel and Crystal. Okay. Definitely want to know this. The Black Wizard Guild. Although, if he joins our party, I might become another wizard. And they're also Grey Wizards, which is basically utilitarian spells, miscellaneous stuff. And the White Wizards are mostly focused on, like a cleric, really. Black Wizard Guild. Key and one of... So I'm guessing he means Ulfin here? Ulfin's flower pots? So I'm guessing he means here. So I should be searching all these flower pots. You will find the guild in a valley to the southeast of Lyramion. The coordinates of the tower are 265 by 306. You will need a ship because the valley is surrounded by the high Bolgar Mountains, Bolgar Burge, which reach far out into the sea. I have heard that the wharves here in Crystal build very good ships. Perhaps you should take a look there. Alright, I need to be writing this down. Marmion went mad and attacked the Eternal Guards. We are being hunted again. It is really bad, but what can one do? Alright, continued. Guild in Valley. Southeast. I didn't notice coordinates when I was walking around outside, but that doesn't mean they aren't there, it just means I didn't notice them. X265, Y306. Need ship. Okay, so we're only getting there from the sea, obviously, surrounded by. High Bolgar Mountains. Will the mountains reach far out into the sea? Okay. Anything else? I ask him. Guild? No. Have you seen a bone around, though? Have you seen this cat? That's right, I forgot to look for that cat in the cemetery. See if he'll mention anything about anything. Let's see if I can say anything about the valley. Alright. Yes, you are right. I should try to save the reputation of my guild and fight Marmion. Have you already got the key to the guild from one of the flower pots in Ulfin's room? If not, let us go and get it together. We can free the path to the tower of the guild with the sphere. What sphere? The guild is to be found in a valley to the southeast of Lyramion. Coordinates are blah blah blah. Have you already brought a ship? We will need one if we want to reach the guild because the valley is surrounded by the high Bolgar Mountains. Blah blah blah. So it's in Ulfin's room. Now we can ask no more about it. So we've got Gryban and Trasric. Interesting. So he comes with 23 gold, helpful, as most people seem to start out with 4 life points. 1 ration. Gryban. He's got clothes and leather shoes, so he is not very good with defense here. So that's him. Do we see his stats as well? Okay, he can speak human and gnome. Stats are not too bad. Okay, human and elf. Yeah, not very strong. Not too intelligent for a magic user. Dexterity not too great. Con is good. Charisma, eh. Luck's decent. He's got magic resistance. Oh, I guess if you're a mage, you become magic resistant. So look at this. He's got 24 life points. I guess these are his spell points? I'm not sure what the SLP here stands for. If anyone wants to clue me in, you're welcome to. 156 gold, nice. So he's already... he's a pretty seasoned adventurer compared to us, that's for sure. Especially he's only got 1 ration. His, he's not too great with his attack and defense, but that's because he's a black wizard. Look at all the stuff he's got. He's got fireball, hailstorm, magic arrows, and tornado. And he's got 2 of these potions and 2 of these potions. Whatever they are. And he's got a robe and leather shoes. And a dagger. Nice. So, he is a frickin' powerhouse compared to all of us. Well, looky that. We got an actual adventure. So, we gotta look in Olfin's room, whichever room is Olfin's. This is not Olfin's room then. Alright, we've been running quite a while, so let's sign off here. I will look for the key in the flower pot next episode, and we'll try to find, I'm guessing Olfin is the name of the tavern owner. I'll try to find him in the courtyard outside and talk to him. So we've got 2 new party members. Freaking awesome! Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.